Is anyone in here stressed out with homework and quizzes and tests? I am as well. With 5 classes a semester, I get overwhelmed on a regular basis. When I get stressed out, I like to take a step back and find something to take my mind off of it. For me, that's playing Sims. I get on my computer, I open it up, and I just escape reality for a couple hours. So my goal tonight is to give you guys an outlet to de-stress with. When I play Sims, I follow 4 main steps. First step is to create a Sim. Then I choose where my Sim's gonna live. Then I build them a home. And then lastly, I get to play with them. So the first step is creating a Sim. When you're creating a Sim, you can really be creative. You can change their hair, their eye color, you can add freckles, you can make them any way you want them to be. You can also create a Sim family if you don't want to just create one Sim. For me, my favorite detail is when I create the ears, because I can make my fiance have the little sticky out ears that he has in real life. After you create your Sim, you move on to their personality. The personality is where you pick some traits, such as, do they like outdoors? Do they like children? Do they get mad easily? It's really where you can express what kind of Sim you want them to be. You also select their aspiration. And their aspiration is kind of like their goal in life. So in the Sim world, you can decide all different types of aspiration, such as being a CEO of a company or having a successful family. It really allows you to build on your Sims. You also can edit their relationships. So you can have a Sim family of sisters or brothers or a mom and dad, grandmas and grandpas, anything you choose. Once you have your Sim and your Sim family complete, you then can move on to where you want them to live. Choosing a location depends on how many expansion packs you have, which is extra content that you can buy to enhance your game. So this is my expansion packs that I have. But what it really breaks down to is, do you want them to live in a city or a suburb? City or suburbs are pretty self-explanatory, but in the Sim world, it's a little different. If you live in a city, you have to live in an apartment. If you live in a suburb, you can build or buy a house. My personal favorite is building a house. When I build a house, I spend 2 to 3 hours just building the outside. I customize the windows, I add landscaping, I give them a pool, I go all out. And here's the real key to the game. On any computer, any Sims game, you hit Control-Shift-C, and you type in Motherlode, and you get unlimited money. So you never have to stress in your Sims game. It's completely stress-free. After I'm finished with the outside of the house, I can move on to the inside, where you can customize every single room to exactly how you want it. Every paint, every floor color, they have it. You also can add little details such as toilet paper in the bathroom, so it really feels like a real house. Now they have a feature where you can even set the dinner table. It really makes you feel like you're actually playing out a virtual life. Once you have created your Sim, chosen where they're going to live, built them a home, and decorated it, you can finally move on to Sim life. Sim life is like any life. You have to feed them, they have to sleep, and they have to use the restroom. But you can also make them be a doctor even if you never want to be a doctor. My personal favorite is the Get to Work expansion pack, which is again just extra content because I can go and play out my lifelong dream of being on Grey's Anatomy through my Sim. Also, on the Sim life, you can create a family and have children, or you can just work out on your treadmill. It really is whatever you want to do. Now that you know how to create a Sim, pick a home, personalize the home, and play your Sim life, you will have an outlet for stress. These were all pictures from my computer game, so please feel free to email me with any questions because I am very passionate about my Sims life and I will be happy to answer. Thank you.